Hi guys, Gail Sylvester here. As we're approaching midsummer, maybe your kid's going away to school at the beginning of September with post-secondary, and we start thinking about what's that going to look like, where are they going to live, are we going to do residence, are we not? Like, it's been such a weird time. Are they even going back to school? Are we just doing homeschool again? So here's what you need to know. So say if you missed the deadline for residents, and all of a sudden you're like, uh-oh, now they are going back into school, but I've got nowhere for them to stay. We do have the option of purchasing a student rental. But here's what you need to know. Most people are like, yeah, I'll just buy a house. My kid can live in it. But you got to qualify. So when we do less than 20% down, you can do it under a second home. As long as you qualify to carry it as a second home with your child living in it, awesome, because that technically is what it is. But if you're looking for a true student rental that includes your child living there, you are going to be looking for about 35% down. And we are a little bit more limited on the lenders that we can work with. So what I suggest is now that we're here, we're passing that end of July cutoff. September's going to be here before we know it. Like, where does the summer go? It goes so quick. Reach out. Let's have a conversation about putting a plan in place in the event that you need to look to purchase a property for end of August, beginning of September. And maybe it is a true student rental down payment we can use from the equity of your home. Like, we've got options, but don't delay. Reach out today. Let's have a conversation about what's that going to look like for September when your kid goes back to school or starts post-secondary. Okay, let's put a plan in place. And we'll talk to you soon.